Here's a main program with just a single rung of ladder code. Let's create a task, call it Shift Report, and let's tell it to never yield. In that task, we'll create a for loop that increments D0 from 1 to whatever's in D100. Normally, we would log data or something like that inside this loop, but that's a subject for a different video. So for our example, we'll just use a math instruction with some trig functions to kill time. Back in main, we'll enable the task and make it edge triggered so it only runs once, which is usually what you would do because normally you would trigger an end of shift report on some event or maybe a certain time each day. But for this demo, we'll add a control bit so we can force it whenever we want to. Great, we have a main scan loop that has one rung of ladder code and one rung that enables our task when C0 is set. Accept that, write it out to the PLC. Put the PLC in run mode, and let's create a data view with our control bit, the loop counter, and the value the loop counter counts to. Let's make that 250 loop iterations. Let's also monitor the actual scan time, the average scan time, and the max scan time. These numbers are all in microseconds. We can see it looks like it takes an average of this many microseconds to execute the program without the task enabled. If we enable the task, holy cow, during the one scan that ran the task, it maxed our scan time out at over 40 times the average scan time. Why is that? Well, because we told it to never yield. On every scan, we're executing this entire loop. If we increase the number of loops, the scan time goes up. Again, we're running through the entire loop on each scan. That is, we're never yielding. Let's reconfigure the task to always yield and write that back out to the PLC. Let's clear that max scan time number. With the task disabled, we get this scan time, and when we enable the task, it only bumps up the max scan time just a little bit. Why? Well, because we set up the task to always yield. So the PLC does one pass through the loop and then exits the task. On the next scan, it does another pass through the loop. Next scan, another pass, etc. So we're only executing one iteration of the loop per scan. What if we change the loop count to 1,000. Look, no change in the max scan time. Why? Well, since we told the task to only do one pass of the loop each scan, it doesn't matter how many passes through the loop we need. Let's take a look at the last yielding option. Let's tell the task it can take up to 1,000 microseconds, but then it has to yield. Write it out to the PLC. With the task enabled, our scan time maxes out at a little over 1,000 microseconds. Exactly what we expect. We call this time allotment for the task a time slice. And look at this. You can change a time slice while the task or program's running. It's just one of the structure members of the program or the task. If I change a time slice and re-execute the task, sure enough, the scan time changes accordingly. Can you use the yielding instruction with a program? Sure. Look, it's the exact same thing. Just like a task, whenever a program hits a yielding instruction, it reacts however you set the yielding up for that program. So once again, do more gives you total control over how your PLC operates. That's so cool. Now, one caution when using never yield. There's a watchdog in the PLC. If your code takes too long to execute, then it's going to assume something's wrong and it's going to reset your PLC, or it may shut down depending upon how you have your watchdog set up. We'll cover the watchdog in another video, as well make sure you're careful that your code doesn't exceed the watchdog time limit when using never yield or when setting up your time slices. Well, that ought to give you a pretty good feel for how all of this fits together. The three main things to remember are, tasks are great for executing things that only require one pass through the code, even if it takes multiple scans. Programs can do everything tasks can do, but they can also do anything that might require multiple passes through the code where you have to keep coming back to check on something like stage or asynchronous communications. And finally, yielding is an awesome way to reduce your scan time. If you need any help with the Do More tasks and programs, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. Don't forget the forums. There are lots of automation professionals there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis. Spend less, do more with Automation Direct.